What's up, J.R. Noble here, and I want to welcome you to Mastering Made Easy. What I'll be covering in this training is how you can take your track and make it louder on a comparable level to other tracks that you might be listening to, but also while maintaining the clarity of the track without kind of distorting the low end or making the high end sound too harsh or too brittle. All right, so really maintaining the integrity of the track, but also kind of getting it loud enough so that it sounds comparable to other tracks that you might be listening to either on the radio, on TV, at festivals, wherever you might be happening to listening to those tracks that you really enjoy listening to. And you want your track to sound on the same level as those tracks as far as quality goes. All right, so what you're looking at right now is actually just two tracks, and I'll explain a little bit more why it's only two tracks even though you see three audio files here. But before I get into that, what I want to do is give you kind of an overview of what you can expect out of this course. So what I'll be doing is I'll be breaking down the mastering process that I used to apply to this track in particular, but I'll also then go and show you how you can achieve a master using a similar process, but just using stock plugins inside of your DAW. And I'll even give you a side-by-side comparison of what it sounds like to do a master using stock plugins versus using some very expensive plugins that you see here. I'll also be sharing with you breakdowns of the different plugins, the different settings I'm using, why I'm using those settings. And I'll also be breaking down some of the technical aspects of certain techniques that I'll be applying or that I have applied in this mastering process. And these are techniques that have been applied by mastering engineers like Luca Pratilesi, who has mastered and mixed for people like Skrillex and Diplo. These are mastering techniques applied by people like Bob Katz, who have mastered for Grammy Award-winning albums. And so these techniques are things that I've picked up from people who have been using this on very, very big records that you've been listening to or have possibly heard. Okay, so why are there only two tracks here, even though you're looking at three audio files? Well, I'll explain that in just a second. Now, if you went through and watched the Killer Mixes video series already, then you'll be familiar with the mixing process that I laid out for you in that training. However, if not, what you're looking at in this yellow file right here, this yellow track, is the mix of a particular song called Third Law of Emotion that I worked on with a couple of artists, Cat Knock and A Romance Junkie. And this is the mix of that I've exported. And so now I just have the stereo wave file in this session. And I highly recommend when you go to master that you take your session and bounce it out of the mix, bounce the mix out, get it out of the original session, put it into a new session so you can master it with some fresh ears. Do this separate from the mix. All right, and so the blue track here is actually the mastered version of this yellow track right here. So this is the same exact track, and so that's why there are only two tracks in this session. So there's the mixed version, there's the mastered version, and then this red track you see here is actually a reference track that I'm using. It's a track by Justin Timberlake called Take Back the Night. So now real quick, what I want to jump into and just make sure that you understand what the point of having this mix in there when it comes to making things louder is that when you're mixing, this is something I talk about in the Killer Mixes, but when you're mixing, you want to mix and use peak level measurements, okay? So you're looking at the peak volume of your mix when you're mixing, and you wanna leave what's called headroom. So you wanna leave a certain amount of decibels before that 0 dB FS mark, so that way you can have some room to add compression and EQ and other things to your mix, to your master, to make your mix sound a lot better as you kind of make it louder. Now, when you're mastering, you're going to watch, you're going to look for a measurement called LUFS, loudness units full scale. And it used to be that you would look at RMS, root mean squared, but instead nowadays the new measurement that most platforms are using is this LUFS standard. So the mastered version that you see here, the master that I have, I reached minus 10 decibels LUFS, and the master I was comparing it to was at minus 7 decibels LUFS. I'll get into the specifics of that and why those numbers are important a little bit later, but I just wanted you to understand what you're looking at, especially in relation to the Killer Mix series that you may have already watched. And if you haven't, I definitely recommend going and checking that out, because the only way you're going to get a really good master is if you have a really good mix to begin with. There are mastering techniques that you can definitely use to enhance the mix and make it sound and improve on the mix, but it's definitely going to help the situation a lot more if you start with really good sounds and a really good mix before you get to the mastering portion. That's just been my personal experience.